You made an invention and consider filing for a patent application? In this video, I'll discuss establishing inventive step of an independent claim using my copy holder as an example. In case you have not seen the second part yet, I recommend clicking the link in the description below. In our last video, we successfully established novelty and inventive step of our independent claim over the prior art available. We ended the problem-solution approach at the could step of the could-would approach, since no prior art available showed a horizontal guidance of an inclined file support. Now consider this. We have filed our patent application and after some time we have received an official communication on the search carried out by the EPO. Apparently, the purpose is entirely different and the prior art copyholder is not at all adapted for alternatingly working on the paper file and on the computer keyboard. However, it's the claim that defines the scope of protection on the one hand and which has to be novel and inventive on the other hand. Thus, we have to check our application for further details, representing the difference between our invention and the newly found prior art. Notably, a rather unimpressive feature turns out to be critical to the ergonomics of our invention. In order not to let the file support accidentally leave the frontmost position, it has to rest in the frontmost position. Such arrestor can be provided by a groove, a notch, a magnet, or the like. Incorporating this feature into our independent claim should thus again establish novelty. However, does this also establish inventive step? Remember, the EPO requires inventions to pass the problem-solution approach in order to examine inventiveness. Check out our previous video for a closer look at the steps we will now go through. The examiner says that this is the closest prior art. So let's accept this opinion and look for the differing feature. This is quite simple since we just established novelty over the prior art. It differs by having an arrestor. The technical effect resulting from the arrestor is that a predefined force is necessary for the file support to leave the frontmost position. Based on this effect, a problem to be solved by the invention can be formulated as how to avoid an unintended displacement of the file support from the frontmost position. The first part of the could-would approach answers the question if the skilled person could arrive at the invention when departing from the closest prior art. A mechanical engineer, based on his average knowledge, knows horizontal guide rails, for example for drawers, having an arrestor in the frontmost position. So the linearly slotted piece in the closest prior art indeed could have been provided by a notch or similar arrestor by the skilled person. So the first step of the could-would approach is fulfilled. In the ultimate step, we have to analyze whether the skilled person when solving the problem also would have been prompted to adapt or modify the closest prior art. Now it's time to argue and becoming creative. The prior art did not even recognize the merit of altering the position of the file support when working. Therefore, it provides thumbscrews in order to permanently secure the file support in a stepless manner in a position which matches the user's ergonomics needs best. The thumbscrews already provide an even stronger fixation of the file support than the arrestor according to our invention. Moreover, an arrestor would clearly violate the concept of continuous guidance, since the file support could not continuously leave the frontmost position, but would overleap adjacent positions when pushed by the user. In summary, we would argue that the skilled person would not have been inclined to add an arrestor to the closest prior art. Therefore, our invention comprises an inventive step. If the examiner accepts this argument, we will have successfully drafted a grantable claim. Check out our website for more information and videos under hoefer-pat.de. Thank you for watching and see you soon at the Hoefer Academy.